Hi, folks. I have the pleasure this afternoon of introducing Dr. Rita, but before I do that, I just want to thank everybody for coming out this afternoon. And I think everybody knows, something like this doesn't happen because of any one person. It takes an effort from the community if you're going to have a community school. And there are a couple of folks in particular that I want to recognize and thank. I want to recognize and thank the church for its assistance with this project. They allow the school to use the garden space that's across the street. That, I think, is a perfect example of the kind of collaboration that a community needs to be successful and to be viable. I also want to say something about the building itself. I've had a lot of folks walk up to me and say, "Boy, you did a great job on that building." And I say to them, "I didn't do anything. Dr. Rita didn't do anything. The building, we don't own it. The building belongs to Old Monroe Mills, which is my good friend Paul Rosenthal back there. And Mr. Rosenthal and his family are responsible for this beautiful building and renovation. And I don't know if any of you have been in it before it got renovated, but what you have in front of you is truly amazing considering the condition it was in when they started on it. So thank you, Paul. Thank you, Bob. Thank you, Jessica. You do wonderful things for this community. And now, I get to introduce Dr. Rita. And looking around the room, she makes me call her that, by the way. I don't think there's anybody in here that's known her longer than I have, except for Melinda Quinn. And I think Melinda's not
here. Riley Tucker.
And Riley Tucker, that's right.
Those two have known
her. But anyway, I first met Miss Rita about 40 years ago. We were a lot younger back then. And I've had the privilege of being married to her for 38 years. To me, it's no surprise that she and the folks that she works with have been able to make this school happen. I've had a lot of folks say, "Well, geez, I don't understand how they can do that and how they can make it happen and make it happen that fast." I never had any doubt. She's just absolutely amazing, and that's all I can say. It's a privilege to be married to her. I think it's a privilege for this community and to have her and to have this vision. So, Dr. Rita.
Well, I want to start out with a quote from my good friend Melinda Quinn, that she used to say this all the time when I was the chairperson on the Walton Commission on Children and Youth, and she was our executive director. "Never underestimate what two mediocre people can do because they don't know when to stop." I just want to thank all of you for being here and helping me and my lifelong dream. You know that I have served public education just about all of my life, and I really believe in it. But one thing I knew is that there are, and it's not just that I know, Garner says there are multiple intelligences, but I was tired of seeing certain children that just were not being motivated by traditional education, and I wanted the chance to teach children in a different way. And one of the things that I say over and over is, what good does it to have a perfect score on the SAT if you don't have integrity? And I think if any of you watched the news last night about the hacker that went into Kennesaw State to change grades, I'm sure he was a very smart child, but he does not have integrity. And I don't know about you, but I would much rather hire somebody with not quite those skills, but had integrity and somebody I could trust. And the way we are handling discipline is they come to me once the teacher has talked to them, and I talk to them about the values and why we don't do what they're doing. There are two rules in this school. One is listen and follow directions. The second is to respect your peers and adults. If you follow those two rules, you're going to be successful in school and successful in life. And that's what I try to help the children to see, that is what we are working for. We work on the academics, but I think it is just as important to learn to be a good citizen. And so the students are responsible for vacuuming their rooms, for dusting their rooms, picking up trash around campus, picking up trash in their room. I took two of the boys the other day to show them how they change paper towels in the boys' restroom. And one of them looked at me and said, "Don't you have employees to do this?" And I said, "No, I have you." So those are skills. And as we know from my parents' generation, that those skills are very important. That ability to realize that nobody is too good to change the paper towels. That it is all, we all do part of everything in order to make this a good world. And that is what we're trying to get across to our children. That it is about learning, but it's about loving to learn and to learn values and to care for three things in Country Day schools. One, you learn responsibility for yourself. You take responsibility. You have responsibility for your neighbor, and you have responsibility for your community. And we are really emphasizing those three things. Next, though, I want to talk to you a little bit about who's here today, and I hope you don't mind, I'm getting old, having to write down names. But I think Richie Seaton, have you seen back there? He is on the Georgia Commission, Cotton Commission. That is very important. They have materials that they have made for the whole state, which is wonderful that they have shared with us. There is a display out in the hallway, because part of what this school is doing is teaching children to have respect and to have pride in this community. And the history of this community is in the cotton industry, and we want them to understand that. We want them to understand why cotton was grown here, the soil, the weather, all the things that made this community a good place to grow cotton. Not only that, Stephen Felker told me that when his family opened the cotton mills, the idea was to help the economy. People were living on farms and starving because of how the weather was that particular year, and a group of men in the community got together and opened the mill. He said none of them knew anything about running a mill, but they knew they needed to do something for their community. Also next, I would like Dr. Frank Flanders from the University College of Agriculture and Environmental Science is not here yet because his class at the university is not over, but he will be here before we leave. He is supporting our program. We have Pam Oakley Nix, who teaches agriculture and horticulture, and that is a daily part of our curriculum here, is going over to the garden and working on growing things and understanding that process of life. I also want to introduce Dr. Don Necco and Steve Nemo from Piedmont College, if y'all will wave. We are working right now on trying to expand in the next few years to high school, and what we will be doing, they'll be helping me in writing curriculum for 9th and 10th grade that is an accelerated curriculum so that students will be able to do dual enrollment with Piedmont College for the 11th and 12th grade. So that is our next big rollout project to be looking forward to for our students. Also, Josh Finley, did Josh come in? Josh is representing Representative Heiss's district. He probably will be in later. I told him anywhere between 4 to 7. Keith Glass, our chief of police. I know Keith is here. Keith, you attended the school, didn't you?
Yeah, we'll bring you some education here.
That's right. So we have a lot of people here who have attended this school. I want to thank Carrie Hendricks and her hard work putting the ribbon cutting together. Greg Thompson, mayor, and his support. And Greg has been supportive all along since I started talking about this. Lee Malcolm, I want to thank Lee because she has done a lot behind the scenes and she's had lots going on and she still keeps us in mind, and the pretty flower arrangement Lee has sent to us. I also want to thank the Rosendahls, but David did not mention Paul's father, Bob, and his nephew, Mark Paul, and Caesar Mondragon, that has worked so hard. The three of him Three of them have been here every day. We have really bonded with them. My granddaughter Rose has added Caesar in her prayers at night because he's here so much. She's worried that Caesar doesn't have days off because when we need something, that's the first person we call. And I just so appreciate the hard work and how the three of them have just, they will do anything and help us in any way that they can. David Keener from Social Circle. David? Yeah, there he is back there hiding. And Dr. Nathan Franklin was here a few moments ago. He may have already left, but I want to also thank Walton County Schools. They have been so supportive of me and tried to support me in my next venture after I retired from them. I just want to thank you, everybody. Please look around in the classrooms. The teachers are here if you have any questions or you want to ask me any questions. Board members are here.
Could we get a picture of the board after this?
Yes, I'd like the board to come up so we can get a picture of the board after this. I guess I need to introduce the board too, if everybody who's on the board would raise their hand. So I have Lee Jordan here, Lisa Smith, Barbara Lewis, Randy Slate, Emily Gallman Russell, Leanne Walker, Christy Slaughter McDevitt, Sherry Malcolm, Melinda Quinn, and Lee Malcolm. Oh my gosh, could I remember? It's been a long day. I get here at 7 o'clock every morning to open these doors and welcome the children. I think it's very important that I open the doors and I welcome them and tell them good morning, and I put them in the cars in the afternoon and tell them to have a good evening. Any questions or anything else anybody would like to know? Well, we have the applications available if anybody's interested for their family. And
what about the tree?
Oh, yes, thank you. We have, this is our donation tree. The low-hanging fruit is things we need that don't cost that much, and it sort of goes up. The high-hanging fruit costs a little more, but we have some buckets, donation buckets, if you would like to take fruit or a leaf and make a donation, we would definitely accept that. And one more person I've got to thank is Riley Tucker. Riley has been here, oh my gosh, he put so much effort into everything. The cotton display Riley put together just very quickly, and she was here, and Doc Malcolm was here, and Ann Deloney, the first day of school, helping us with little kindergartners crying and all, and they were just so wonderful and helped everybody get in the right place and comforted. And just thank you, and please enjoy the refreshments.
And we have more apples over here. We run out of apples over there.
1, 2, 3.
Representing George Walton Academy for this year's festivities are your ninth grade representative, Miss Ashley Ray Carter. Ashley is the daughter of Dr. and Mrs. Steve Carter. She is escorted this evening by her father, Dr. Steve Carter. Ashley runs varsity track, plays on the varsity basketball team, is a JV football cheerleader, part of the Gavel Club and Latin Club. Ashley is a member of First Baptist Church of Covington. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Ashley Ray Carter. And now, also representing the ninth grade, Miss Melissa Rainey Gish. Melissa is the daughter of Greg and Teresa Gish. She is escorted this evening by her father, Greg Gish. Melissa plays on the varsity volleyball team, is a member of the varsity swim team and the Gamma Club. Melissa also plays Awana Club volleyball. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Melissa Rainey Gish. And now, please welcome Miss Spring Z. Rawl. Spring is the daughter of Jay and Faye Rawl. She is escorted this evening by her father, Jay Rawl. Spring runs cross country and track and is a member of the Gavel Club. Spring also enjoys trapeze and being part of the Walton County YAB and Monroe First United Methodist Church YAB. Spring attends Monroe First United Methodist Church. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Spring Z. Rawl. And now representing the 10th grade, Miss Caroline Ewing Hart. Caroline is the daughter of Josh and Molly Hart. She is escorted this evening by her father, Josh Hart. Caroline is a student council representative and runs varsity cross country and track. She is also a member of Interact Club and the Anchor Club. She attends St. Albans Episcopal Church. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Caroline Ewing Hart. And now please welcome Ms. Taryn Lee Shelner. Taryn is the daughter of Todd and Beth Shelner. She is escorted this evening by her father, Todd Shelner. Taryn plays varsity softball and basketball, is a member of the Beta Club, Spanish Club, and FCA leadership. Taryn also enjoys being part of youth group at her church and being an elementary church camp counselor. She attends Corinth Christian Church. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Taryn Shelnut. And now one of the 11th grade representatives, Ms. Stevie Lee Manning. Stevie Lee is the daughter of Jerry and Ginger Manning. She is escorted this evening by her father, Jerry Manning. Stevie Lee is part of the National Honor Society, vice president of the junior class, and a varsity cheerleader, part of the Anchor Club, Gavel Club officer, Spanish Club officer, and plays varsity tennis. She also enjoys being a part of the McDaniel Traber House Junior Committee. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Stevie Lee Manning. Now, please welcome Miss Libby Lee McDaniel. Libby is the daughter of Larry and Lisa McDaniel. She is escorted this evening by her father, Larry McDaniel. Libby is a varsity cheerleader, a tech dog, and part of the National Honor Society. She is a member of the International Pop Culture Club, Latin Club, Beta Club. She also enjoys horseback riding and trapeze. She attends church at Grace Monroe. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Miss Libby Lee McDaniel. And now it is my pleasure to introduce the senior members of the homecoming court. One of these ladies will be crowned the 2016 George Walton Academy homecoming queen. Now, first, Miss Sophie Merrill Chapar. Sophia is the daughter of Albert and Nadine Chapar. She is escorted by her father, Albert Chapar. Sophia plays varsity basketball and is the AIM Club president. She is a member of the Beta Club, National Honor Society, Gavel Club, Spanish Club, Socratic Circle, and Women of Technology. Sophia enjoys playing the guitar and piano. Sophia's favorite school memory is winning the basketball region championship in 2013. She attends St. Elias Eastern Orthodox Christian Church. Tonight, Sophia's special first grader, Carter McCarthy, is here to give his terrific senior a good luck hug. Carter? Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Sophia Merrill Chapar. And now please welcome Miss Lexi Medeiros Coleman. Lexi is the daughter of William and Christy Coleman. She is escorted this evening by her father, William Coleman. Lexi runs varsity track, is a student council executive vice president, and member of the Gavel Club. Lexi is also selected as a debutante of Monroe and is a USEA eventing competitor. She is a member of the Way of the Cross Baptist Church. Lexi's favorite school memory is going to state with her 4x1 relay team. Lexi's special first grader, Mac Ferguson, is here to give his amazing senior a good luck hug. Mac. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lexi Medeiros Coleman. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Cullen Elizabeth Downey. Cullen is the daughter of Frank and Katie Downey. She is escorted this evening by her father, Frank Downey. Cullen runs varsity cross country, is a part of the Gavel and Spanish clubs. She also enjoys being part of Team Up Mentoring and True North. She attends Grace Monroe. Cullen's favorite school memory includes going to state with her cross-country team. Cullen's awesome first grader, London Locken, is standing on the sidelines ready to wish her wonderful senior good luck. London! Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Cullen Elizabeth Downey. And now, please welcome Miss Sarah Reese Howard. Reese is the daughter of Rob and Barbara Howard. She is escorted this evening by her father, Rob Howard. Reese is a varsity cheerleader on the varsity tennis team, executive vice president of student council, president of the Gavel Club, leader of the Socratic Circle, vice president of the Interact Club, vice president of Spanish Club, senior representative for NHS, Beta Club, Anchor Club, literary team, news crew anchor, captain of senior call-a-thon team, and yearbook staff. Reese also served on a Hugh O'Brien Youth Leadership Junior Staff and member of Walton Youth Leadership. She attends Monroe, First United Methodist Church. Reese's favorite school memory is dancing in Venice on the Italian trip with Dr. Cook, Ms. Reagan, and Ms. Bowers. Reese's fantastic first grader, Addie Grace Croker, is here tonight to wish her special senior good luck. Addie Grace. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Sarah Reese Howard. And now, please welcome Miss Alexa Morrison. Alexa, Dr. Morrison, and Alexandra Jaquit. She is escorted this evening by her father, Morrison Jaquit. Alexa is a yearbook editor, representative of the Spanish Club, secretary of International Pop Club, Anchor Club, member of the track and field team, part of the Socratic Circle, and the NHS Beta Club. Alexa also enjoys being part of Youth Advocacy Board, playing piano, and dancing at Charlotte's School of Dance. Alexa's favorite school memory is going to homecoming with Kaya Samuel and dancing the night away. Alexa's favorite special first grader, London Lachlan, is here tonight to give her awesome senior a good luck hug. London, once again. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Alexa Morrison Jaquit. And now, Miss Taylor Lee Wolf. Taylor is the daughter of Dr. William Wolf and Lee Wolf. She is escorted this evening by her father, Dr. William Wolf. Taylor is the captain of the varsity cheerleading squad, runs varsity track, student council representative, part of the Beta Club, National Honor Society, Latin Club, Anchor Club, secretary of the Internet Club, member of FCA. Taylor was also selected as a debutante of Monroe. Taylor attends First Baptist Church, Monroe. Taylor's favorite school memory is cheering on Friday nights since she was a freshman with Mimi Crouch. Taylor's fantastic first grader, Bailey Briscoe, is here tonight to wish her a wonderful senior. Good luck, Bailey. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Taylor Lee Wolf. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor to present the 2015 George Wolf Academy Homecoming Queen, Ms. Ansley Crouch. Ansley is a freshman at Georgia State University Perimeter College and plans on transferring to Georgia College and State University in the fall of 2017. Ansley's major is pre-nursing. She is escorted this evening by her father, Jeff Crouch. Now, for the highlight of the evening, the crowning of the 2016 Homecoming Queen. The 2016 Homecoming Queen will be announced by Headmaster Billy Nicholson and crowned by 2015 Homecoming Queen, Ansley Crouch. Assisting with the festivities is the Associate Headmaster, Dr. Dan Dolan.
2016 Homecoming Queen, Taylor.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, your 2016 Homecoming Queen, Ms. Taylor Lee Wolf.
Hey, I'm Isaac at Reboot Computer Company, and we're going to give you the Reboot Tech Tip this week. I had a request about what to do our tech tip on this week, and it was to give some tips to senior citizens. Senior citizens didn't grow up with computers, so it can be a little more difficult, to deal with, and it can be a little scary, really. I did have a couple tips, get you a computer. It's not going to hurt you, but go ahead and get you one, go slow with it. If you can get one of your kids or your grandkids or something like that to teach you how to get on the internet, we can actually show you, or if you can get on the internet, you can be shown how to go to what's called YouTube, where you can watch some videos about computers. There's actually step-by-step instructions for pretty much anything that you can think of. Yeah, I replaced my transmission control module in my VW from looking it up on the internet the other day, which I probably shouldn't have done myself, but there's step-by-step instructions about how to do it. And so I knocked it out, transmission works like a champ, I'm driving again. There's stuff that's very beneficial to people that's on the internet, that's on YouTube. What I would say is get you a computer. Start slow. It's difficult for someone to actually mess up a computer bad enough for it not to work at all. Now, if you go around and you're actually just clicking on stuff all over the place and, typing in all kind of craziness and you don't know what you're doing, you can mess up the computer. You know, but it's like driving a car. You don't drive your car into the side of a building. You know, you just don't do that. With a computer, you just don't go clicking on everything, especially while you're on the internet. You know, if you get on the internet, have a set destination that you want to go. You know, if you want to watch a video, go to YouTube. If you want to search for something on the internet, you go to Google. You know, you don't want to go clicking on all these crazy sites and end up with a bunch of viruses and have to bring it to somebody like me to fix. You know, so if you're not sure, it's okay to ask somebody. You know, other things too is there's classes you can take. You know, we do classes actually here at Reboot, but you can go. Sometimes they do classes at places like the library. I want to say certain senior citizen centers, they'll do classes. You know, you can find stuff online for it also. But you know, the key thing again is to go slow, you know, play with it some. You know, I hear a lot of people getting recipes off the internet, which is great. I just pulled a recipe for homemade ice cream off the internet, I don't know, last week, and it's great. So again, there's lots of benefits, you know, to being on the computer, having the internet and stuff like that. It's nothing to be scared of. And you know, feel free to call Reboot if you need some help. We'd be happy to help you out, and we'd love to take the time. Again, this is Isaac with Reboot. Remember to give your computer the reboot, not the boot.
Hi there, I'm Emily Russell, Director of Marketing and Business Development here at Clearview Regional Medical Center. Thanks so much for tuning in and joining us today. As always at Clearview, we have new services that we're introducing, new physicians that we're recruiting to better serve our community and everyone that lives here, our families, our neighbors. We just really believe in providing safe, quality, and compassionate health care to our community. And so one of our latest endeavors to do that is through physician recruitment. And I am proud to welcome with me today Dr. Joel Garrison. Welcome, Dr. Garrison.
Thank you, Emily.
Dr. Garrison is a family practice physician, and he's going to be located here in Monroe, just off of Breedlove Drive at Clearview Primary Care at Breedlove. So, Dr. Garrison, tell us a little bit about yourself. Where are you from? What brought you to the area?
I'm originally from Bradenton, Florida, which is just south of Tampa. But I was raised a Bulldog fan, and I went to the University of Georgia for my undergraduate degree.
Very good.
Which helped me fall in love with this area, Northeast Georgia.
Yeah.
And I was lucky enough to meet my wife there as well.
Very good.
So we decided after medical training to settle in this area.
Fantastic. Okay, so undergraduate school, University of Georgia, and medical training. Where'd you do your medical school?
Went to Lake Erie College of Osteopathic Medicine.
Very good.
And I was at their satellite campus, not in Erie, Pennsylvania, but in Bradenton, Florida.
Very good, very nice. So truly a Florida native.
Yes.
And moving up to Georgia now. So tell me a little bit why you chose the city of Monroe.
So I was looking for a smaller community, something my wife and I could be involved with, and we love the Northeast Georgia area, and we're very attracted to Monroe. And we've been here about 4 weeks now and absolutely love it.
Fantastic, wonderful. We love anytime that anyone else loves our little city of Monroe. Those of us that are here all the time, of course, we love it and are here by choice. So we love it when we can find somebody else that also recognizes the charm and everything that
absolutely.
Monroe brings. So you mentioned the Lake Erie School of Osteopathic Medicine.
Yes.
So tell me a little bit about osteopathic medicine. You are a doctor of osteopathic medicine as opposed to
yes.
an MD.
Correct.
What kind of are the nuances and the differences?
So I get that question a lot. My degree says DO, mm-hmm. Compared to my colleague physicians who say MD.
Mm-hmm.
The difference is kind of twofold. First off, it's the same training as our MD colleagues and the same residency.
Mm-hmm.
The
mm-hmm.
difference is we are additionally trained in musculoskeletal medicine as well as practicing the osteopathic philosophy of medicine, and that really centers around the body's ability to heal itself and also giving the body the right tools it needs mm-hmm. to live healthy and productive.
Okay, great. So when you see a medical doctor that has received training, you've basically received all of the exact same training, just an additional
Correct.
Add-on in the musculoskeletal field.
Yes.
So how does that actually translate to your patient care? What does that look like? What services are you able to offer?
Sure. So I like to think of it as a very holistic approach.
Mm-hmm.
So not looking at the chart, but actually talking to the patient and the family and learning a little bit about the disease process with the patient, and not necessarily focusing on the disease, but focusing on the patient and customizing a treatment plan to get the patient back to normal.
Okay, very good, very good. If I am correct, I also understand that doctors of osteopathic medicine with the musculoskeletal training are able to do manipulations and hands-on with patients.
That is correct.
Tell me a little bit about that. What does that treat? What does that look like? How does that work?
So part of the difference in being a DO is the hands-on training, the additional training in the musculoskeletal system. So we're able to recognize and treat anything from an acute injury to a chronic injury, a lot of aches and pains. A treatment program would consist of an evaluation, an exam, a thorough history taking, and then a hands-on examination to find out what's going on with the muscles, the bones, the joints.
Okay, very good. So I would assume someone that has chronic back pain, neck pain, any particular joints that you definitely specialize in or don't specialize in?
So myself personally, from head to toe.
Okay, very good.
So I treat the whole individual. Whether that's neck pain, down to knee pain, to ankle pain.
Okay, very good. And by doing that hands-on manipulation, I would assume that might go hand-in-hand with rehabilitation and therapy, physical therapy, those kinds of things.
So I love to partner with physical therapists to incorporate, the holistic treatment plan for the patients.
Very good.
Something where they can see the physician and then incorporate other community resources into ultimately restoring homeostasis to the body and getting people happy and healthy.
Perfect. Very good. You know, the body is a wonderful and amazing thing, and how it all works together sometimes is very complicated and to me even difficult to comprehend that everything works the way that it does and as well as it does. Mm-hmm. So I love the osteopathic approach to medicine and the fact that it is a bit more holistic and focuses on the body really healing itself and having the tools to heal itself. So I think that's a great, great philosophy. So speaking of philosophies, kind of what is your philosophy on medicine? What do you think is the best approach with your patients? How do you like to practice?
Sure. So I think the couple big points is the body's a unit. It's all interconnected. Nothing is separate from itself and the body. Next is the body has a natural way of healing itself if given the right tools, whether that's medicine or with manipulation. Sometimes restoring just balance to the body can help the body heal its own illnesses. And then also structure and function are interconnected in the body. So restoring back the proper structure can help the body function ideally.
Very good, very good. So, you know, right now there's a lot of press and publicity about healthy lifestyle. You know, you can't go anywhere or do anything without reading about eating healthy or exercising. Kind of what's your philosophy on incorporating that in with treatment plans and with just treating patients with any various illness?
Sure. I think that's critical. It's number one. I think what you put into your body is what you're going to ultimately get out of it. So starting by eating healthy, incorporating exercise, those things that you know, we've been told all our lives to do, they're really important.
Yeah, it's just difficult to do them sometimes. It's
Absolutely.
Difficult to find the time to do them.
Yep.
And actually, Dr. Garrison is going to be hosting a Lunch and Learn that you'll hear more about during the month of October, and we're going to be talking about those ways to stay healthy and to stay fit as we age and to incorporate all of those proper nutritional aspects into your daily life. Right. So there are a lot of neat programs out there right now. I mean, whether you shop at your local farmer's market or maybe you even do a food subscription service. I don't know if you're familiar with any of those. I have lots of friends that do a food subscription service, and they basically send you a box full of food with all the ingredients.
Yep.
And so there are lots of different ways that we as individuals can get the nutrients and the vitamins that we need through the foods that we eat. Just sometimes you have to be a little bit more creative than others. So very good. Well, wonderful. Well, anything else about yourself or kind of, well, tell us who you treat age-wise and what type of conditions and whatnot.
Sure. Thanks for asking. I'm a family practice trained and board certified physician. So I treat all ages, all ranges, from pediatrics up to geriatrics. And happy to see anyone.
Awesome. So you truly are that family doc that you can see all the way from birth to death.
Yep, you can stay with me the whole way.
That's wonderful. That's wonderful. I think that really creates an awesome continuity of care as well for individuals. And I know sometimes for children, it's great to be able to see your physician as a child and then even as you grow up still too.
Sure.
Not have to worry
about
changing.
from childhood to adolescence to adulthood. And I love making connections with families mm-hmm. as well, and understanding from the children to the parents to the grandparents.
Yeah. Well, and that truly is a wonderful thing when you can treat the family as a whole unit mm-hmm. And recognize patterns in behavior and in habits and perhaps even just in genetics as well.
Absolutely, and that plays a big role.
Absolutely. So if you're treating the parent for something, then you might be more likely to look for that sign or symptom in the child as well, I would think.
And same with grandparents.
Yeah, that's a great perspective. So seeing Dr. Garrison is truly a one-stop shop as far as family practice goes. Infants all the way to geriatrics, being able to see that full spectrum of care. And what all types of conditions do you everyday treat?
Sure, so the big ones we see are chronic conditions, mm-hmm. high blood pressure, diabetes, mm-hmm. that affects a lot of our community, mm-hmm. so those are the big ones, but also acute conditions, so any sore throats, mm-hmm. To fevers in kids. And then of course with the musculoskeletal aspect, any aches or pains, whether acute or chronic injuries.
Very good. So really just about anything that's wrong with you.
Sure.
You can at least get that process started, and if they need more specialized care, yep. direct them from there as well. Well, that's wonderful. Well, we are just excited here at Clearview to have Dr. Garrison on board with us. You know, we really are proud when we can get great quality physicians to our community. That means a lot to us as a hospital and to us as citizens of Monroe and living in Walton County. It's just important that we recognize the fact that we don't have to travel outside of Walton County to receive really great health care. We're able to bring it here to our community, and we're just glad that you're going to be part of that now, Dr. Garrison.
Thank you,
Emily. That's wonderful. Absolutely. Well, if you are interested in scheduling an appointment with Dr. Garrison, his office is located at 704 Breedlove Drive right here in Monroe, across from the old hospital. That's where he is currently, and their phone number is 770-267-8467. We will be accepting most insurances at that location. You can call and see him or Dr. Allen. Dr. Julie Allen is also family practice and is also in that practice. So if you're not able to get in to see Dr. Garrison just yet, you can perhaps start with her and then we can transition you over. But Dr. Garrison will be accepting new patients starting in October. So give us a call. We'd be happy to get you on the schedule and treat you and your family. So very good. Well, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Emily.
And we look forward to seeing more of you.
Yes, I'm very excited to join the family of Monroe.
Very good. So if you're looking for a new family practice physician, we encourage you to call Dr. Garrison at Clearview Primary Care at Breedlove. If you'd like more information on Dr. Garrison, you can check out our website at www.clearviewprimarycare.com. You can find information about all of our primary care locations. We have two here in Monroe, one in Grayson, and one in Social Circle. So no matter where you are geographically, where you may live or where you may work or play, we have an office near you. And then if you're looking for more specialized services and it's not something that we offer through our primary care network, you can always call our physician referral line and be referred to a specialist. We'll match you up with insurance, location, perhaps even bedside demeanor. We're able to kind of match you with a physician and give you recommendations on who to call. And that number is 1-877-933-2762. Also, we have several upcoming events geared towards our senior population, whether it be a Lunch and Learn event. We have one coming up about medications. Dr. Garrison's going to be doing one about healthy lifestyles. And we'll just be continuing to add to that Lunch and Learn series throughout the coming months. And you can check out that calendar on our website at clearviewregionalmedicalcenter.com. As always, thank you so much for trusting us to take care of you and your family. And as always, stay healthy.
Hi, I'm Dr. April Mitchell, and I'm a veterinarian at the Monroe Vet Clinic here in Monroe, Georgia. And today I'd like to talk to you guys about the importance of not giving your pet, your dog or your cat, or whatever animal you may have, over-the-counter medications that aren't approved for animals. We have had several incidents where our clients have been under the impression that it was okay to give their dogs ibuprofen. Ibuprofen is actually highly toxic to dogs and cats and can cause severe stomach GI ulceration and also kidney failure. It is very dangerous to give to our pets. It is okay in humans, but not in animals. That's just one of the examples. Tylenol is not safe at all to give to cats and is very not prescribed often at all in dogs and can be very dangerous to dogs as well. And unfortunately, there's a lot of misrepresentation of these drugs on the internet and through Facebook and things like that, you don't need to take advice over the internet about your pet's health. You need to seek a reputable veterinarian or a licensed veterinarian when discussing medications with your dog. Human pharmacists are not trained in veterinary medicine, and they do not understand all the pros and cons and the consequences of giving human medication to dogs and cats. So it's not that they don't want to help people, but they are not trained in that type of medicine. So please, when you read something online, see who wrote it, make sure that they really did write it, and take it with a grain of salt, and please consult a veterinarian, because once your dog has massive kidney failure, more than likely, unfortunately, you're gonna lose your dog, and it's very, very upsetting to the owner of the pet, and of course to the pet itself. It's not their fault that they were given medication that should have never been administered to them in the first place. So please, if you have questions, feel free to give us a call. We'd be glad to help. But just because it's on the internet does not mean it's safe at all for your pet. Please come see us at the Monroe Vet Clinic if you have any questions. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Joel Burnsett, and I am with the Walton County Extension Service here in Monroe, Georgia. And I'm here to talk to you today about our ag update, to kind of give you an idea of what's going on in the ag world or the lawn care, what you should do for your yard or your garden. So the first thing I want to talk about is fall gardening. So it's kind of the transition from your summer garden, which is usually the most popular, and now we're transitioning into fall gardening. If you're an avid fall gardener, then you already know what to do, but if you have any questions, you can give us a call. But if you're interested in fall gardening, we have tons of information available here at the Extension office that we can pass along to you, read over it with you, answer any questions you may have to plant some of the popular fall crops, which are usually collards and turnips, things like that, the leafy greens that people tend to like, and they're very popular around here during the fall. So now's the time. We even have a fall garden planting chart, and gives you the dates to plant the vegetables for fall, so you'll know you'll be on track for that. Fall lawn care, most people just cut their grass in the summertime and they forget about it, but if you do want a pristine, best looking lawn in the neighborhood or on the block, then it's a year-round process. So now's not the time to just stop mowing once we get into our cooler temperatures, but you're going to want to put a fall application of fertilizer. So the month of September would be good for another application. And also the month of September is when you're going to start putting out pre-emergent herbicide for your winter annual weeds. And what that pre-emergent herbicide means is a herbicide that you're going to put on your lawn now that will prevent those weeds that come up during the fall and winter months. So if you get it out now, then you're not going to have those weeds during the fall and winter. And then you'll go into putting your pre-emergent out for the summer in the late winter. That's kind of how that rotates. So if you have any questions about that, about what pre-emergent herbicide to put out, because it does depend on what type of lawn you have, and then also any questions about what type of fertilizer to put out for your fall application, give us a call here at the office or drop in. I'll be happy to talk with you. The last thing I would like to talk about is our Master Gardener class here at the Extension office through Walton County and through the University of Georgia. We are in the stages of planning a new Master Gardener class that will take place right here in Monroe. We're hoping to have it on Tuesdays and Thursdays starting in January and going through the end of March of 2017. So classes on Tuesday, Thursdays, we're hoping from 9:30 to 11:30 is the time that we set. There is a fee that goes along with that class, which is $150, but that includes all the class materials, and you're getting high-end education from extension agents and specialists and professors from the university and across the state. It's a great class. We have a great group of master gardeners in Walton County, and we're hoping to expand that group of volunteers. So if you're interested in that, please give us a call here at the office or stop by, and we'll be happy to answer any of the questions. Our office number here is 770-267-1324. Have a good day. Thank you.
Hi, this is Jody Johnson. I'm here with the Recreation Report. We have a lot of good things going on here at the Recreation Department, including some football, which we've started our recreation football season. We had our jamboree last weekend, and weather was great. I had a little rain shower late in the evening, but nothing hurt. Got a little uniforms broke in well. So a lot of good football was played. Cheerleaders came out and participated, played half games to get the teams oriented with playing. Some teams played back-to-back half games. Some teams sat a game or so in practice. But we always start our season off with what we call the Walton County Jamboree, where all the teams get to play two halves of a game against two different opponents. So now our regular season has kicked off here in Monroe, Loganville, and Social Circle. Predominantly our games are played on Mondays and Tuesdays, and then we have of about four out of the seven Saturdays that we have games, including the what we call our homecoming, which is a fundraiser that's used to promote the local league. So good luck to all our recreation teams as they start their season. And as always, it'll culminate with the Community Bowl, which the top six teams in each age division, we have 8-and-unders, 10-and-unders, and 12-year-olds that will play in the Community Bowl. Also have 6-year-olds as well. They'll play in the Community Bowl, top six teams, and they'll play for the countywide championship. After that, we'll have what's called All-Stars. We put together teams from our areas, usually Loganville and then Monroe and Social Circle combined for All-Star teams. And in the past, we've played GRPA, which is the Georgia Recreation and Parks Association All-Star State Tournament. This year, we're gonna change it up. We're gonna host our own tournament. It's gonna be called the Patriot Bowl, and it's gonna be November 12th through the 13th at Felker Park. A lot of the local teams in the area will be participating in the Patriot Bowl, including our own teams. And the reason behind doing our own tournament this year is just the timing of it. The GRPA tournament went into the middle of November, and a lot of our teams are ready to participate in basketball or at least get this season over so they don't have to practice a month without playing. So hopefully this year's the first annual Patriot Bowl will be a huge success for our program. I also want to remind everyone that usually when we start one program, we have another one that we're registering for. And this year, our basketball registration is going on September 12th through the 17th. Cost is $70 to participate in this program. And again, we provide a full uniform for you. We have ages 5 through age 18. That can participate in our basketball program. So make sure you go out to Felker Park. There is limited space available for everyone to participate. We're doing Monday through Friday from 10 to 5 and Saturday 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. So make sure you get in. Cost is $60 per participant. It's $120 if you're out of county. Again, 5s through age 18 if you're in school. Control date is of December 31st. That's how old you are by the end of this year is what age you will participate in our basketball program. Most of the games are played at Felker Park or at Meridian Park or down at South Walton or at Niwal Park here in Monroe. So, the games are fairly local and they run through the end of February. And then we'll start our baseball and softball seasons as well. Other programs that are going on right now, we do have our fall baseball and softball program that's in full swing, and we'll continue playing that through October 15th, our soccer season. We've begun practices, and games will start here in a couple weeks as well. We do know that we have a lot of other activities going on at the Recreation Department, including all of our exercise programs at the community centers. We have our senior aerobics classes, which are really busting out the seams. We have around 100 to 120 seniors that meet at 10 o'clock in the morning at our community centers. Again, the best information to receive for all of these programs is through our website at waltoncountyga.gov. We hope to see you at the park real soon, running a pavilion or walking on a walking trail or a nature trail. There's a lot of beautiful things out there for you to see, and the weather is starting to cool off late in the evening, so it's a great time to get out and exercise and be healthy. So we hope to see you at the park soon, and remember, sportsmanship starts at home, and we hope to see you at the park real soon. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot for tuning in. As always, we'll show you some of the dogs and cats that are available for adoption here at Walton County Animal Control. You know, it's just September and we kind of hit a milestone yesterday. We had our 1,700th animal turned in for the year. 1,700 animals so far this year. That's a high, high number. So we really need you to do your part. If your dog's not spayed or neutered, go ahead and get that done. There's just no need to not do it. Now the prices are so cheap. There's a great place in Walnut Grove now. They have a clinic. It's Paradox Spay Neuter Clinic. Really affordable in spay and neuter there. They also do vaccines and all kinds of other services there. In fact, they have a vaccine clinic coming up. It's going to be on Saturday, September 24th. This is right near the Walnut Grove High School, Paradox Spay Neuter Clinic. They're going to be doing rabies shots for $15, distemper parvo vaccines for $15, also all the cat vaccines are $15 each, and you can get microchipping done for $25 as well. So that's going to be Saturday, September 24th from 10 to 2 at Paradox Spay Neuter Clinic. And not just that clinic, but every week they have highly discounted spays and neuters. That'll really help out your local shelter so you don't have that unwanted litter of kittens or litter of puppies that has to come here. The other option as well for vaccines is at Tractor Supply in Monroe. They're doing vaccine clinics now every Saturday. It used to be just twice a month, but now every Saturday from 1 to 2:30. They have a lot of different vaccine packages with the vaccine, rabies, microchips that range in prices. So you can come by the shelter, pick up a flyer, or go by their clinic there at Tractor Supply. No reason to not get your pet taken care of. It's the responsible thing to do, and it'll keep animals from coming into here and then facing that possibility of euthanasia. We've got several dogs and cats. We're still in that busy summer season, so a lot of animals. You can look online at waltonpets.net or come by the shelter. We're here for viewing Monday through Friday from 2 to 4:30. You can just come in, have a walkthrough, and see what's available. And as always, $40 adoption fee. And now that includes heartworm testing, vaccine, combo testing on the cats, a lot of great stuff for just $40. So don't forget about your local animal shelter. Now we'll show you some of those dogs and cats that are here.
This is Jackal. He's a domestic short hair. He's about 6 months old. He's really sweet. He just needs a good home.
This is a lab mix male, about 3 years old. Already neutered, very friendly.
This is Miss Ruby Jean. She's a champagne and white colored lab pit mix. She's about 3 years old. You see, she's very healthy. She needed a good home. I think she was the owner surrendered, but she's looking for a good home.
This is Ginger. She's a pit mix. She's about 3 years old. She's very friendly. She has a really good personality, and she just needs someone to give her a good home.
You've known for years that this is the number one cause of lung cancer, smoking. That's why the Surgeon General issued this warning. But do you know the number one cause of lung cancer for non-smokers? It's in this room. You can't see it or smell it. It's radon. Radon is an invisible radioactive gas that seeps inside your home from underground. It can build up to dangerous levels without notice. Now the Surgeon General has issued another lung cancer warning. And whether you smoke or not, breathing radon can cause lung cancer. That's why you need to have your home tested. Protect your family. Call 1-800-SOS-RADON. Heed the warning. Have your home tested, because radon problems can be fixed.